Good evening. Our Savior's Lutheran Church acknowledges and honors the Yankton Lakota people upon whose ancestral homelands we gather for worship today, as well as all our Indigenous siblings who love and continue to care for this place, this land, and who still call it their home.
Please pray with us. Holy One, you meet us in every time and place, on the cusp of the promised land, out under the stars, deep within the sanctuary, sitting at the table, even at the end of everything. Send your Spirit among us, nestle us in the warm shadow of your wings, open our hearts to notice you everywhere, even this time, even this place. Amen.
A reading from Deuteronomy. When you have come into the land that the Lord your God has given you as an inheritance to possess, and you possess it and settle in it, you shall take some of the first of all the fruit of the ground, which you harvest from the land that the Lord your God has given you, and you shall put it in a basket, and go to the place that the Lord your God will choose as a dwelling for his name. You shall go to the priest who is in office at that time, and say to him, Today I declare to the Lord your God that I have come into the land that the Lord swore to our ancestors to give us. When the priest takes the basket from your hand and sets it down before the altar of the Lord your God, you shall make this response before the Lord your God. A wandering Armenian was my ancestor. He went down into Egypt and lived there as an alien, few in number, and there he became a great nation, mighty and populous. When the Egyptians treated us harshly and afflicted us by imposing hard labor upon us, we cried to the Lord, the God of our ancestors. The Lord heard our voice, and he saw our affliction, our toil, and our oppression. The Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, with a terrifying display of power, and with signs and wonders. And he brought us into this place and gave us this land, a land flowing with milk and honey. So now I bring the first of the fruit of the ground that you, O Lord, have given me. You shall set it down before the Lord your God and bow down before the Lord your God. Then you, together with the Levites and the aliens who reside among you, shall celebrate with all the bounty that the Lord your God has given to you and to your house. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We're so glad you could join us for our Savior's Lenten devotion today. This is our Lenten series, You Are Here, where we're exploring God's presence in every physical place in the world. Certainly that means that we'll hear about God's presence in all the places of the Bible, especially if you're looking at our Lent devotion book. You'll get a picture at some of those places, and you'll help imagine them in your mind with the pictures of the Holy Land. But also, it means that God is present with us even in our own lives, in the places where we go and where we work. God is present with us in our homes, in our workplaces, and here at church. So each week during Lent, what we're doing at Our Savior's, we thought, you know, you folks come to worship here and you get to see our marvelous sanctuary and our Celebrate Center and join with us in worship there. But what about all the other places at church where ministry happens and where we experience God's presence? So each week we're going to go to a different place in our church where God is at work. And we're going to spend time with the people who do ministry there or with other people on staff who serve this place. Today we're going to go to the church library at Our Savior's. This is the 60th anniversary of the church's library, and I got to tell you, it's unlike any library at a church that I know about. It's my daughter's favorite library in town. You may have heard me say that before, and that's because the library really has something for everyone. There's stuff for little kids, there's stuff for adults, there's stuff for people that want to learn, there's stuff for people that just want to be entertained. This is truly a library in the fullest sense. Which also means that the Our Savior's Library helps push our boundaries. It helps give us a greater sense of what God is doing in the world through the written word. And I want you to think about your love of learning. I want you to think about your favorite books or the times when you have found yourself hooked into a world that you didn't know about or that you had never been able to imagine on your own. And then I want you to remember the passage that we just heard from Deuteronomy, where God tells God's people that they one day will stand in a place with the harvest of the land, and they will praise God with that harvest. Well, God is telling this word to people who have never owned land before, who have never grown a harvest or grown their own crops. God's telling this to people who have never been able to imagine that they could have something that belonged to them. And in this written word, God gives them a vision of a future that is so marvelous they never imagined it could be theirs. That's the power of the written word. That's the power of God's capacity to work through our imagination, to draw us forward into a reality we didn't even know exist. And that's the amazing thing that you will hear happens every week at the church library at Our Savior's.
The library is just like, it gives you the tools that you need to connect your faith to everyday life. Kind of like the hook on a train, it keeps the train together. We have the tools that you need. If you need an answer to a question, either a secular question or a non-secular question, if you just want to gain knowledge of the world around you, of different places and different people, or if you just want to be entertained, we have fiction and family movies. We provide you with the tools that you're looking for. We are like a family within a family here. I think if Our Savior's had a Cheers, it would be the library. We are kind of the social hub here at the library. I'm going to try to remember your name when you come in. I'm going to try to remember what kind of books you like or if there's a new book that I think you might be interested in. We check on each other here in the library. The library is different things to different people. Be it if you just need a quiet place to come and sit and meditate on God's word, or maybe you want to stop in with your coffee and take a look through the paper, or maybe you just need to sit with your spouse and wait for your kids to be done with their activities. Or maybe you just want to check in here with your friends. Like I said, the library is different things to different people. But it's a good social place to be. We have a lot of great Lenten resources. We have some devotionals for families, for individuals. And then we've got a lot of great nonfiction about the Holy Land. The theme for Lent this year is place. And we tied that in with books take you places. So we have a little display in the window of books from the Holy Land. And then for the kids, when they come in and they check out a book, they get to choose an egg from the Easter basket. And inside the egg is a little treat, along with a Lenten activity that they can do either by themselves or with their family. Just something to kind of cause a little self-reflection and make the world a little better place. Some of the eggs say, you know, pick up a piece of litter, or write a thank you note to your teacher, or call an elderly person and just ask them how they are. Just little things like that that we can, like I said, reflect on ourselves and help to make the world a better place this Lent.
Now it's time for us to pray. Please join us as we pray. God, the whole world calls out for your presence. Together we share our concerns for all who are in need. Today, God, we pray for peaceful places. Let countries, peoples, and homes know God's peace. We pray for loving places. Let relationships, companionships, and friendships experience God's love. We pray for healing places. Let every body experience God's healing. We pray for safe places. Let all who seek refuge experience God's safety. We pray for just places. Let all the ends of the earth experience God's justice. God of every time and place, send your spirit of peace, love, healing, safety, and justice to every part of creation. Break what needs breaking. Mend what needs mending. Renew what needs renewal. We pray in the name of Jesus, whose presence illuminates all places. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Now, friends, thanks for joining us for this devotion time. As you go from this place into whatever the day has in store for you, go with the blessing of God. Remember that this blessing follows you no matter the places to which you are called. Remember this blessing waits for you, even where you least expect to find it. Be blessed in the name of God, who inspires, inhabits, and ignites us now and forever. Amen.